I'll protect you from the hooded claw. Keep the vampires from your door.
Frankie Goes to Hollywood. It is taken from the 1984 album Pleasure. Well, Welcome to the Pleasuredome. That's it. It was the third single to be released, which also topped the UK charts there. And in many other European countries, not sure if it ever made it into the US. So this is another Eurocentric song, I believe. However, if you do know it, then I'm sure you are also aware of it, that there's a lot of orchestration in the song, which gives it a really, well, a very powerful song, actually. Then again, if you would all strip it down and take it away, you end up with a pretty easy song to play. So, what we have is the key of E minor. If you want to match it with the original recording, just place the capo on the first fret and then you will have it in the absolute key of F minor. Nowadays, or in recent years, or at least later, I've never heard him do it in that particular key. So it's just take the capo off, play it in E minor there. So, in that key, we would have for the fretting hand the chords 1, 4, and 5, E minor, A minor, and B minor. Remember, E minor is a relative minor of G major, so the same chords are in there, just different numbers for those chords. E minor is now 1, A minor is 4, B minor is 5. Then we have chord 6, which is a major chord, C major, and chord 7, also a major chord, which is D. And then we're already there, actually. There are a couple of different chord shapes you might want to use for, in particular, like the intro and outro, because, for example, you need an E minor up here on the 7th fret, and then a power chord here on the 5th and 7th fret, a D, actually, and then with a low E there in the bass. That's how the song goes. Actually, the intro starts off with a triad, and I will show you those shapes, of course, in this lesson. In the outro, you do need what I showed you before. From E minor to G with an E in the bass, and then to C with an E in the bass. His guitar player uses this particular chord shape, to D with an E in the bass, and up to E minor again. Like so. On stage, that is. On the original recording, it's a little different there, which I will point out as well. Now, so in my opinion, by far the most important aspect of playing the song is really about the strumming hand, because you do not have this, you know, all this orchestration. So you do need to, you know, attack the strings in a way which allows you to build it up and to take it down and so on. You want to kind of copy, dynamically speaking, how it goes. So I will point out a few of the things that you can do to make that happen, but it does mean pay very close attention to what you do with the strumming hand. Don't go full on banging on the guitar or putting your pick too deep between the strings. It's not going to work out. Okay, now, so all those things that I just talked about will be in this lesson, which you can check out at totallyguitars.com.